Good evening. It's Friday, 5th of January, 2018, and basically a vlog update. I've got a confirmation of a book for one of my classes for this coming semester, which starts Monday. And I only need to purchase one book because I have books for the other classes already. Some are transferring over, and the others are merely one's not using a book, and the other one's using a book that I used for a previous class. So yay. Let's see what else. I've been doing last couple of days. Been doing tests using my DSR, a Pentax K7. And still learning how to use how to take pictures and take videos with it, and yes, the K5, which came out later, is better at is probably most likely better at video logging. But I need to still learn how to work the tools, and kind of like the challenge of working with this and trying to learn its limitations and trying to adapt. And you know, I'm not comfortable with it. I got this, last year, through a bid that the Humane Society of Oregon was holding, and it was just the body, and then I got the lenses separately on eBay, and then my brother got this TacStar microphone for me, I think for my birthday. And that's great. So it works fairly well. Anyway, what I've learned, at least definitely confirming today, was that I was getting this graininess, and I'll bring it up as an example. This video was taken in the 3rd. January, about 2 days ago, and as you can see, I don't know if you can see it, but there's like graininess here, and graininess around the area. And let's see if I can. Trying to figure out how to work with green. Can't really see it. Kind of see it. And then yesterday, I was working with natural lighting. It was low because it was in the late afternoon. But there was a lot of green. So anyway, did that test, and then I did a very test outside with natural lighting, in the natural lighting, and that seemed to work a lot better. Let's see. I think this was the start of it. Semi-indoors. Yeah, this is just outside my room. Outside the door.
Hey, how's it going? It's 5th of January, 2018. This is a semi-outdoor visual test to see if I can eliminate the grain that I've experienced with previous tests. There'll be three videos. One right here, which is kind of closed. And then one in a well-lighted area, and then outside, which I
All right, and so what I found was that inside there was some grain, and maybe all the lights were the same colors and there wasn't much variance. That could have been a reason. With the outdoor, there's light everywhere. And that seemed to, at least from the samples that I got, that the graininess was pretty much not there, or at least tolerable. Let's see, we'll try to get an indoor shot. And there's some grain. This is Kern lobby. I did too much moving around, and I think I was trying to experiment and would later see if I could use that as transition shots. I've been watching some YouTubers giving advice on working with handhelds, particularly a Canadian by the name of Peter McKinnon. Sort of got introduced to him watching Casey Neistat. I like to watch people at work with stuff and try to pick up on it, what they are, can teach, especially watching Sarah Dietschy and John Hill, watching them do the work. And try to decide what I want to use, or at least try for. Let's see, back to the forecast. So anyway, it's moving the camera a lot, and it's got, like, getting a lot of grain inside. Then outside, what happened? Yeah, here we have, again, a lot of movement, but there's very little grain. And so that's pretty neat. There's a lot of movement. Just inside at the same level from the just previous video outside, and this is the hallway. And I was trying to see if the indoor shots, and it did require some green. Is that someone's face? Shut. Was one of the new students, but yeah, so more lighting, more varied lighting. My next test, which I'll probably do tomorrow, is to see if multivariate indoor lighting takes away the grain. So I'll turn on the light that's next to the entry door, and then also I have a flashlight. Which is my old flashlight when I was in the army, but I modified the lens so it's not military spec anymore. Whereas the military spec lens has a lower light so you can, be less detected. This one has a very bright LED light. Works great for personal civilian use as a normal flashlight. Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's my next test, and Saturday I'll pick up one of my books, the book I'll need for next semester, and that's pretty much it. How long is this going on? 9 minutes. Anyway, thanks for watching. It's a little bit slightly rambling. That's pretty much it. Trying to clear out the machines, my machines directories, getting them organized for next semester. Trying to see what software I could use that'll help me with my schoolwork. It's been hit or miss. There's been some that I could see some improvement if I were to use it. I'm not sure if I will, sort of wait and see. And I guess that's it. Thanks for watching, and have a wonderful evening and weekend. Hunt out.